This shows the attachment of the muscles on the radius and ulna. The posteriorly on the radial tuberosity is insertion of biceps brachii. Lateral to it is a big insertion of supinator muscle. Below that is the insertion of pronator teres. Still below that is the insertion of the brachioradialis. On the anterior oblique line is the origin of flexor digitorum superficialis. Upper 3/4 is flexor pollicis longus, and lower 1/4 is the insertion of pronator quadratus muscle. Finishing the ulna side by side, the anterior surface of the coronoid process is the insertion of brachialis muscle, and there are few slips of the other muscles. Important muscle on the ulna is the flexor digitorum profundus, which also arises from the interosseous membrane, anterior surface as well as medial surface till the posterior border, and lower part is an oblique line for the origin of the pronator quadratus muscle. The posterior surface of radius also shows the insertion of the supinator, as well as on the radial tuberosity, the insertion of biceps brachii. In addition, there are the muscles arising from the posterior border, abductor and posterior border and posterior surface. Abductor pollicis longus arises from both the radius and the ulna. Extensor pollicis brevis only from the radius and interosseous membrane, whereas extensor pollicis longus from only the ulna and the interosseous membrane, and extensor indices also only from the posterior surface of ulna and the interosseous membrane. And here the huge origin of flexor digitorum profundus. Flexor is arising from the medial surface of ulna, and on the lateral surface of the olecranon process and on the shaft is the origin of a weak muscle, the anconeus, and the most important muscle is on the superior surface of the olecranon process of ulna, which is the triceps brachii. The origin of supinator is below the radial notch of ulna, from the ulna, and it embraces the whole of radius on the posterior surface, lateral surface, and to the anterior surface, so that the act of supination can be done efficiently. Shows the back of humerus to show the origin of the lateral head of triceps brachii from a small area, and most of the posterior surface gives attachment to the huge medial head of triceps brachii, whereas the long head arises only from the infraglenoid tubercle. All these three heads join to get inserted into the olecranon process of the ulna. This is the important extensor of the elbow joint. Shows from the radius, anterior surface of radius, the flexor pollicis longus muscle arises, passes under the flexor retinaculum to go to the distal phalanx, base of the distal phalanx of the thumb. And the huge muscle, the flexor digitorum profundus, arises, passes again under the flexor retinaculum, divides into four tendons, and they pass straight to the base of the distal phalanx of the index finger, middle finger, ring finger, and the little finger. In this, it shows the attachments of the important muscle, the pronator quadratus, which is arising by a ridge from the lower part of the ulna and goes and gets inserted into the anterior surface of the radius at its lower end, and also onto the medial surface.